Hello friends, this video on electricity part 12 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Please make sure that you have watched all the videos till part 11 before going ahead with part 12. Now we will introduce another important, let us now define another quantity associated with it, that is electric power. So just now we saw that the source energy got dissipated as heat across the resistor in the electric circuit. Now the rate at which this energy gets dissipated in the circuit is known as electric power. Normally we have talked about power in one of our previous lessons where we say that the rate of doing work is defined as power. So in this case also, since we are talking about electric circuits here, so here the rate at which the electric energy is dissipated, that means the rate at which work is done in bringing the charged particle from one point to another, that is defined as electric power. So it is denoted by a capital P. The SI unit is similar to power, that is watt. So how do I define 1 watt? It is defined as the power consumed by a device carrying 1 ampere of current when operated at a potential difference of 1 volts. Because power is equal to VI. That is what we derived in the last slide, right? So if I want to define 1 watt, it has to be 1 volt multiplied by 1 ampere of current. So the power consumed when 1 ampere of current is operated, when 1 ampere of current passes through the device when operated at a potential difference of 1 volts. Now applying Ohm's law, we can also write that power is equal to V square by R, or power is equal to I square by R. Let us now try to solve few problems based on whatever we studied so far. So here comes problem 1. It says, several electric bulbs designed to be used on a 220 volts electric supply line are rated as 10 watts. How many lamps can be connected in parallel with each other across the two wires of 220 volts if the maximum allowable current is 5 amperes? So in this case, the bulb is rated as 10 watts. That means the power is 10 watts. And what is the supply line? That means what is the potential difference from the source? That is 220 volts. Right? So using this value of power and potential difference, we can calculate the value of resistance. We know that P is equal to V square by R. So using this, we can say P1 is equal to V1 square by R1. So from this we can calculate R1 as V1 square by P1, that is equal to 220 into 220 divided by 10. So this comes out to be 4840 ohms. Now it says that there are several electric bulbs which are connected in parallel so that the maximum allowable current is 5 amperes. So now we are able to calculate the value of each resistance, but we don't know how many such resistances are connected. So let us suppose that the number of bulbs is n. So we assume that the number of bulbs is n and the resistance of each such bulb is 4840 ohms, right? So what would be, and all these bulbs are connected in parallel, that is also mentioned in the problem. So what would be the equivalent resistance of that combination? 1 by RP, if RP is the equivalent resistance, will be equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. This will be added for n times because I have assumed that the total number of bulbs is n. So now we can say that 1 by RP will be equal to 1 by, now the values of R1, R2, R3, all these values are same, they all are 4840, so we can replace them by R. So we can say this is equal to N by R. So from this we can say that RP is equal to R by N ohms. Let R or R1, whatever you want, you can replace it with any of these. So now we know the value of R1. Now For the entire circuit as a whole, if you look at the circuit as a whole, how much current is allowed to be flown in the circuit? The maximum allowable current is 5 amperes. And what is the potential difference across the circuit? That is 220 volts. So using these data from Ohm's law, we can calculate the value of equivalent resistance of the circuit. So if the equivalent resistance of the circuit is RP, we can say V is equal to I into RP, right? So from this, we can calculate RP as V by I, that is equal to 220 divided by 5, which comes out to be 44 ohms. So now we make use of this equation and we say that N is equal to R1 by RP. So R1 was 4840 ohms, so put it as 4840 divided by 44. So this comes out to be 110. So that means in order that a current of 5 amperes flows through this circuit, we will have to connect 110 electric bulbs in parallel with each other. Let us look at the next problem. It says, compare the power used in the 2 ohm resistor in each of the following circuits. The first circuit is a 6 volt battery in series with 1 ohm and 2 ohm resistors. So how will the circuit look like? So let us look at the first part first. So you have 2 resistors, 1 ohm and 2 ohms, and they are connected with a battery of 6 volts. So this is a battery of 6 volts. So we have to compare the power used in the 2 ohm resistor. So we have to calculate the power across this resistor. Now let us first look at, how will the current flow in this circuit? Let us suppose some current I flows through the circuit. The same amount, since these two resistors are in series, so the same amount of current will flow through each of these resistors. So let us try to calculate the current flowing through this circuit. What would be the equivalent resistance of the circuit? 1 ohm plus 2 ohms, which is equal to 3 ohms. Now the current through the circuit will be equal to V divided by R equivalent from Ohm's law. V is 6 ohms, R equivalent is 3 ohms. So this gives 2 amperes. That means 2 amperes of current will flow through this circuit. So now concentrate on the 2 ohms resistor, because we have to calculate the power used in this 2 ohm resistors. Now, what is the current flowing through the 2 ohm resistors? 2 amperes. So current through 2 ohm resistor is equal to 2 amperes. Therefore, power across the 2 ohms resistor will be equal to I square R. What is I? I is 2 ampere into R. R is again 2 ohms. So this is equal to 8 watts. So that means 8 watts of power is used in the 2 ohm resistor. Let us look at the second part of the problem. It says there is a 4 volt battery in parallel with a 12 volt and 2 ohm, with a 12 ohms and 2 ohm resistor. So this means here you have two resistors which are connected in parallel with a battery of 4 volts. So this is a 4 volt battery, this is 2 ohms and this is 12 ohms. So in this case, first of all, we have, again in this case also, we have to calculate the power used in this 2 ohm resistor. So for this, we will have to calculate the current through this resistor. Now what is the potential difference across these resistors? The potential difference across these two points is 4 volts. Potential difference across these two points is also 4 volts. Therefore, let us first calculate the current through 2 ohm resistor. That will be equal to V by R as per Ohm's law. So V is equal to 4 volts divided by R is 2 ohms, which is equal to 2 amperes. So here also 2 amperes of current flows through this 2 ohm resistor. Therefore, the power through 2 ohm resistor will be equal to I square into R, which is equal to 2 square into 2, that is equal to 8 watts. So in this case also, the amount of power that is used in the 2 ohms resistor is 8 watts. Thank you. Please visit examfear.com to watch free educational videos, try free online tests, get the best quality study materials, study from the best tutors and mentors, and much more. Thank you once again.